Nope. That's not right. Damn it. Nope. There.
Lockdown lifted. You are now safe to resume working.
Estevez, come in. Facility. Sublevel 1. You copy?
No. Turn back. Area is extremely hostile. Floor 1. I'll need help.
successfully affecting reality, we always think of Alan Wake and his writing. This could be due to recency bias or simply the amount of recorded evidence skewing our opinion. But also, I wonder if writing's very nature is an advantage. The text can describe events in such explicit detail. The story gives the shadow a blueprint, a map of what to make real. But not all art is like this. Music, sculpture, dance, cuisine, in our case, a painting. When the source material is open to interpretation, how will the shadow choose to interpret it? I think Diana will find the question very interesting. Most likely, she already has an answer. That's why I love her.
My team was on sublevel one. I knew they were in danger. The Marmonts turned innocent people into tools using the FBC's authority. They thought they were untouchable out here, hidden away in the woods. No. Actions have consequences. And I'm the consequences.
Sublevel one.
That's a
research. Ugh, you fucking bastard. Jules Marmont killed my team. He was taken by the Shadow. I'm sorry. I should get that gun while I'm up here.
Scientific. I mean, who came up with that? Shadow.
Comes to my lab and treats me like some kind of assistant. A putain d'assistant, moi? I run the lighthouse. This is my facility. Mine! He cannot just walk in here for 1 week, make some speeches, and then fly back to New York. Espèce de crétin! Prétentieux! The jackass thinks he's a fucking rock star! And he made fun of the name. Oh, the Shadow. The Shadow is good. It's evocative. He's just a jealous, spoiled little child. And I will make it so everyone can see this. I will make it so no one even remembers his name! Tous ces imbéciles là, hein? They all think I am a pencil pusher. They think I do not have the mind for such work. Eh bien, ils verront. Ils verront! I will take what they think is possible. And I will break it.
get me down to sub-level 5. And this should get me past any other problems.
There was a crack in the lake house. The Marmonts had let the lake in, but the water could not flow. It became trapped, stagnant, went bad. The truth was controlled here. The art was not art, just content for the experiment. The contrived overlap rebounded on itself, compressing, compounding, reflecting, and refracting. An urban legend and a murder in constant imbalance, cause and effect hopelessly entangled. Arranged wrong, the dream logic flawed. The feedback loop doubled and redoubled, out of control. The pressure kept building, looking for a release.
Bingo. That key card's gonna get me to sub-level 5. On these bastards. shadow had changed Jules Marmont into a hostile, paranatural entity. That made everything simpler. No arrest, no paperwork. I could put him down like the monster he was.
Sublevel 2.
Lane was found dead in his cell this morning. It's an unfortunate setback. But when a door is closed, a window is opened. I believe that's the saying. Lane may be gone, but he left us with a goodbye present. A final piece of art. This piece is different. It's raw emotion, pure truth. He put everything he had into this one. Literally. Every reading we take is off the charts. This is what we have been waiting for. It is the key. I will achieve what no one has before me. Not darling, that arrogant shit. Not my selfish harpy of a wife.
So, we have a painter and a painting that can talk. Clearly connected. But Lane was dead before any of this even happened.
Finally see me for the genius I am.
Thank you. 3.
Water dripped from the ceiling as Diana stared at the folders stacked on her workstation. Each one was a branch of research. Drip. Some were thin, some thick. They represented years of her life, her work, dissecting the act of creation and examining the bloody pieces. Bringing in live subjects had been her idea. Drip. Bureau leadership denied their request. But after HQ went into lockdown, she took advantage of the chaos and got her artists. Jules had whined about the optics. Diana ignored him. Now in her office below the waterline of Cauldron Lake, she considered how to proceed. Jules was convinced the page they had found would come true. It promised disaster. A situation out of control. Impossible. Diana was always in control. Drip. Drip. She needed answers. She needed to quantify, to define, to control.
March 7th, 2018. Notes regarding Dr. Emil Hartman, founder of the Cauldron Lake Lodge, where he manipulated artists in an attempt to control the power of the Shadow. I've gone through his notes, which were confiscated by the Bureau after his arrest in 2010. Next.
found new pages written by Wake. You must have gotten Rudolph Lane painting again. His bullshit pedestrian methodology cannot produce results before mine. I have to go faster, no matter the cost. We're still behind our projections. The more the machines can produce, the closer we can calibrate them to Wake's style. But proper calibration takes a lot of raw material, and production is slow. No. We're changing directions. The hypothesis remains unchanged. Imitating Wake's writing style will allow us to generate art capable of linking with a threshold. Our live subject should match Wake's style much faster. People can be calibrated just like a machine. You simply have to push the right buttons.
Marmonts were holding a painter here. Rudolph Lane. Does that ring a bell?
The shame of a man!
I think you are, or were, Rudolph Lane.
Himself! A self-portrait! Make them see!
Look, I might be able to help you. But I need information, cooperation.
No push! Just insane!
Rudolph Lane was dying. Both murderer and victim. Red hues ran down his hands. Was it scarlet? cadmium. Too vivid to be maroon. Names don't matter, he decided. Color was pure. Inspiring. For the first time in years, he wanted to paint. A self-portrait. To say goodbye. No. To make them remember. To make them see what they did. He slapped his hands against the wall to steady himself. He began from there. No brush, just himself. The strokes were crude, violent. The pain, misery, and hate he'd endured there. The fire in his eyes and hands and bones all spread into the shape of a man. It was quick. Natural. Like a heart attack. He slumped down to the floor, smiling at the anger he left smeared across the wall.
Wish the elevator would stop moving. Ooh, nice office. Concentrated black rock powder. Need to keep an eye out for more of these.
Diana sat in her office. A weak desk light kept the darkness around her at bay. The silence of the archive suited her. She scowled at a series of graphs when the room turned red. Alarms blared. Breach detected. Then the walls of the archives rumbled. A tremor in the bones of the facility. One by one, the red lights went dark as a wave of nothing poured in from all sides. Diana stood, but there was nowhere to run. The sheer depth of the darkness terrified her. She realized they had done this. Her and Jules. Their ambition. Their hatred. Her desk lamp flickered. In the brief moment before it all went dark, she thought of Jules' smile.